This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about finding the inverse of a matrix. So just to review and make sure you understand about inverses, if we have two square matrices with the same dimensions, and we can multiply them together, and we get the identity matrix, then we say that those two matrices are inverses of each other. So I'm going to take these two matrices that I have and see if they are inverses. The first matrix is 2, 3, 3, 4. The second matrix is negative 4, 3, 3, and negative 2. Okay, so to multiply them, I'll multiply 2 times negative 4 is negative 8. And then 3 times 3 is positive 9. Negative 8 and positive 9 add up to 1. I'll go to the next position. I want 2 times 3, which is 6, and then 3 times negative 2, which is negative 6. Adding those together, we get a 0. Down here, I'm multiplying 3 times negative 4 is negative 12, and 4 times positive 3 is positive 12. Those add up to 0. And finally, I want to multiply 3 times 3, which is 9, and 4 times negative 2, which is negative 8. 9 minus 8 is 1. And I've ended up with the identity matrix. Okay, so now what I want to do is take a different matrix and see if we can find its inverse. This is really fairly easy. What we're going to do is take that matrix and I'm going to make an augmented matrix out of it. I'm going to augment it with the identity matrix. So I'm starting with a 2x2 matrix, 2, 4, negative 3, negative 4, and I'm augmenting it with the identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. And now I'm going to do reduced row echelon operations on this augmented matrix. After I've gotten the reduced row echelon form on the left, what I'm going to find is the right side of that matrix is the inverse of the original. Okay, so let's do this. I've got a 2 in this first position here. I want that to be a 1. So what I'm going to do is multiply it by the reciprocal of the 2, which is 1 half. So I want 1 half times row 1. That's going to become the new row 1. So row 1 will be 1 half times 2, which is 1. 1 half times 4, which is 2. 1 half times 1, which is 1 half. And 1 half times 0, which is 0. The second row will stay the same. That's negative 3, negative 4, 0, and 1. Now in the second row, I've got this negative 3 in the first column. I want that to become a 0. So I'll take the first row, multiply it by 3, add it to the second row, and make that the new second row. So I want 3 times row 1 plus row 2 becomes the new row 2. So the first row is going to stay the same. We can put that in now. That's 1, 2, 1 half, and 0. And now we'll multiply that by 3 and add it to row 2. So 3 times 1 is 3, plus negative 3 is 0. 3 times 2 is 6, plus negative 4 is positive 2. 3 times 1 half is 3 halves, plus 0 is 3 halves. And 3 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. I've got a 2 in the second row, second column. I want to turn that into a 1. So I'll multiply by the reciprocal of the 2. Once again, I'm multiplying by 1 half. That's going to be 1 half times row 2 will become the new row 2. So let's continue that over here. The first row is going to stay the same. So that's still 1, 2, 1/2, and 0. The second row is getting multiplied by 1/2. So 1/2 times 0 is 0. 1/2 times 2 is 1. 1/2 times 3/2 is 3/4. And 1/2 times 1 is 1/2. The only thing left to do is to get rid of this 2 in the first row, second column. So I want to multiply the second row by negative 2 and add it to the first row. So I want negative 2 times row 2 plus row 1 is going to become the new row 1. So negative 2 times 0 is 0. I add that to 1. I still have a 1. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. I add that to the 2 and I get a 0. Negative 2 times 3/4 is negative 3/2. When I add negative 3/2 plus 1/2, I get a negative 1. And negative 2 times 1/2 is negative 1. I add that to the 0 and I get another negative 1. And then the second row stays the same. That's 0, 1, 3/4, and 1/2. So in my matrix now, on the left side, I've got the identity matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. On the right side, I've got the inverse of the original matrix, negative 1, negative 1, 3/4, and 1/2. I've got that written down over here. I've got the two matrices, the original one and its inverse. Let's check those and make sure that they're actually inverses. So I want to multiply 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. And then 4 times 3/4 is positive 3. Negative 2 plus 3 is 1. Next, I want negative 2 times negative. Positive 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. And then 4 times 1/2 is positive 2. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. I'm multiplying negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. And then negative 4 times 3/4 is negative 3. So I've got positive 3 and negative 3 is 0. And the last thing I need is negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. Negative 4 times 1/2 is negative 2. 3 plus negative 2 is 1. And there's the identity matrix. Okay, so just to go back to that original first step, all you do is take the matrix that you want to take the find the inverse of. Put it into an augmented matrix where the right side of the matrix is the identity matrix. Do your reduced row echelon process until you get the identity matrix on the left. Let me find that. And you're going to have the inverse matrix on the right. Okay? And that's it. Take care. I'll see you next time.